back, so in case they give me a little too much trouble, why, I can always do something to them. But anyway, here is Terry and Junior, and I believe right here Terry is going to be working on takedowns. Takedowns is taking a man off his feet, and then he'll stop if he gets Junior off his feet. These two, they're going about three-quarter speed right now. Terry is going for the leg. He has not thrown his legs in there far enough or fast enough, and Junior just stepped back a little bit, eased back, and got away from him. Now Terry is wing locking him, and I guess a lot of the Olympic wrestlers and amateur wrestlers around the country will recognize that move. It's what we call a fireman's carry. Takes in, gets the leverage on Junior, takes him over, lets him go. They both get back up to their feet again. You see a very competent instructor walking around there as Dory Funk Sr.
Would you be an instructor or a referee here?
No, I wouldn't be a referee. They're just working out, you know. And if I see them make a move that I don't think is the best thing to do or anything, why, I will tell them and tell them how to change their leverage on it a little bit. And they could do the same for me, because if you're watching, it's a lot better to tell what the move will be than if you're out in the ring there. Terry just made another pretty good move there. He's moving around. Junior, usual cool, calm, collected self, but he went cool, calm and collected and landed on his back there, because Terry looked at him. You always keep your eyes on a man's eyes, and that way you know where his feet are going. It sounds a little funny, but you just watch his face and his eyes, and you know what he's going to do. There's Terry. Junior let him go for that one. Terry's starting to go for a spinning toe hold, and I tell him, stop it. Terry says, okay. He just wanted to show that he had him in a position to do that. And Junior's a Junior now, calm down. You know.
Well, the object is just to stay in shape and also maybe up with something new.
That's right, but still he's working on the takedowns. How are you going to get a man off his feet? How are you going to get him down to that mat? It's strictly, essentially, wrestling has been... Now,
there's the old pro.
Now, Terry, he said, let's see you do it, and how would you stop it? Well, I said, this is the way I stop it. And I let Terry go for the leg, and when he went for the leg and grabbed that leg, I was already moving for the other thing, because I knew that was what I was going to do, because I knew Terry was going to go for the leg, because I told him to go for the leg. Now, you can follow all that. Now Terry's throwing me in the ropes. I say, wait a minute. Now I'm showing Terry. See, now Terry, he wasn't too smart right there, was he? Because he was going to stop me. I said, Junior, what are you doing? And while Terry was looking right at that, I turned around and got his leg. Well, that's just part of the...
Left arm hanging almost helpless, but he was still able to use that right effectively. Smashing away at the side of the head of Mike Graham. Classic battle between these two young men. Mike Graham sent through the rope. Graham coming up. And again, Sonny Myers tolling the count. An elbow to the base of the skull of Mike Graham again. And now Funk, that adrenaline flowing. And Funk beginning to move somewhat in desperation. And Mike Graham firing back. Now Funk flailing away with everything he's got. Again, that headbutt. Mike Graham maintained his feet, however. Both men crashing into each other. Terry Funk staggered, trying to maintain his balance, trying to stay on his feet. Graham trying desperately to get back up, and finally Funk collapses through the canvas. This match has taken its toll of both men. A grueling battle thus far. A suit played by Terry Funk and Mike Graham. After the pile driver that he had taken earlier, the series of headbutts, referee down, and I'm sure he feels that this is going to be the three count. But Graham again managed to wriggle out from underneath, and you can hear the crowd coming alive as they realize the tremendous struggle that these men are going through. Excellent move as Graham blocked that one into a backslide, and Funk powers out of it. And now Funk is totally desperate. Time is running out for this Texan. Rolling reverse cradle, but Funk, those powerful football legs, moving him out from that particular pinning combination. Good shoulder smash by Terry Funk. Funk coming off again. This time, Graham was set and ready. underhooking that arm now and applying that pressure again, concentrating. And as he does, twisting that arm now, down on that shoulder, putting on more pressure. And there's his dad, Eddie Graham, and what prouder moment for any father than you see right now as he realizes that his son has certainly carried on that.
The American dream, Dusty Rhodes. There you see him moving into the ring, going up against Terry Funk, younger brother of the former world heavyweight champion, Dory Funk Jr. Terry Funk. You'll note now as he gets into the ring, his eye covered. This is the eye that was severely injured by Dusty Rhodes earlier, and Terry Funk is seeking vengeance. And this man is unquestionably an ally of Gary Hart's army. Am I right, Mr. Hart?
The man came to Miami Beach for one thing, to get revenge on Dusty Rhodes, because Terry Funk is just not a normal individual. He wants revenge. He lives on violence. He's probably the most violent man in the wrestling business. He's even more violent than Dusty Rhodes, as you can see right there. With his eye taped up, he has a patch over his eye, had been injured very, very badly by Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, but you see him throwing 280 pounds through the ropes.
And there's 280 pounds coming back through the ropes, and Mr. Hart, it appears to me that you were interfering here.
No, I wasn't. This was a tag match. If you see, I'm in my tights, and I was just trying to get a few free shots in on the big white whale.
Dusty Rhodes still dominating at this point.
You realize that Terry Funk is from probably the greatest wrestling family in the world today. Violent. Him and his brother both have came here to take care of Dusty Rhodes for me. They have came in as bounty hunters for Gary Hart. I'm the only man in wrestling that can acquire services such as Terry Funk, ex-world's heavyweight champion, Dory Funk Jr. And Terry Funk wants to get a hold of Dusty Rhodes worse than anything else.
Terry Funk hurtling Dusty Rhodes out of the ring, follows him out of the ring at this point. And here's where anything goes and does go. Watch here, Terry Funk smash down on that railing. And watch Dusty Rhodes throwing caution to the wind, smashing away at Terry Funk. Rhodes coming back into the ring, Funk back into the ring. And I must admit that Terry Funk can take a tremendous amount of punishment.
Like I said, Terry Funk has one thing in mind and one thing only, revenge, and he'll pay any price. If you notice, Terry Funk, as I said before, now here you go. Here comes a little bit of the sweet revenge. Two, three.
For one fall, two a finish. In the red corner at 260 pounds, the international champion, Terry Funk. And in the blue corner at 295 pounds, the North American heavyweight champion. And this is a title match for the North American heavyweight belt, Cowboy Bill Watts.
The introduction of this next match, a match that you probably never thought you would see on television. A match that could fill the arena, in any arena anywhere in the world, as two champions battle for supremacy and a chance to meet the world heavyweight champion for the apex title of the world heavyweight division, the Oklahoma Stampeder, Cowboy Bill Watts, who has regained his North American title, taking on the international champion from Humburger in Amarillo, Texas, Terry Funk. Two big men, ring-wise. Both of them know all the holds and know how to apply them and use them. Main eventers all over the world, not only just the United States, but all over the world. Cowboy Bill Watts is proud that he's just regained his North American title, a title that he never lost, and definitely is considered number one, and hopes to use this match to prove it. And to the winner goes all the prestige, plus the North American title, because that title belt is on the line as Watts defends against Terry Funk, brother of Dory Funk Jr., the former world heavyweight champion. Currently the international champion, and he wants the North American title bad, where there can be no dispute, and clearly stamp himself as the number one contender for the world title held by Jack Briscoe. There's Funk with his unorthodox manner and his vicious tactics. And the Oklahoma star is in trouble as Funk will not let up and continues to work on the arm of the Oklahoma Stampeder. Alfred Neely on his knees to check that everything's in order. You can hear Terry Funk ask referee Alfred Neely to ask him if he wants to give up, but there'll be no submission on this hold. However, it is weakening. Can lose the use of that arm, as you can see on the screen, and is all ready. And that left arm, as Funk is unrelentingly working on the cowboy Bill Watts, therefore rendering it almost useless, but he has another fit. There's Funk using the hair of the head to bring him down. But Neely, remember, the referee must actually see the contestant violate a rule. He cannot go by hearsay or what fans say, but he has to actually see it with his own eyes according to the rules of the National Wrestling Alliance. He's working on that arm, going high in the air and bringing down all 285 pounds of Terry Funk. Bill Watts. His arm must be suffering from the excruciating pain. And look at that. Look at that. High in the air and now using the leg right across the throat of Watts for 1-2. A two count, and Bill Watts was able to use his strength to throw Funk off, and he landed between the second and third strand. There goes a smash from the elbow of Funk, and there's a judo chop across the throat. Hey! Coming off that rope, Bill Watts using his assisted attack now. One arm almost gone, but he still has plenty of power in that good right arm, and that you can see the top of the boot, which is legal. And Funk is all entwined in the rope across the ring. But Watts is dishing back some that he has taken the past few minutes. And he's more than ready. The North American champion defending that title here on television. Funk, the international champion, is in trouble. And when the referee releases his leg from being entwined in a rope, he falls all the way to the cement floor. Walking the ring, trying to erase the cobwebs out of his head and be ready for action. You have to have all your mentality going for you in such a title match between these two statues. Two great, great heavyweight wrestlers, the international champion Terry Funk and North American title holder Cowboy Bill Watts. Battle for supremacy and prestige that goes to the winner of this match. That's where he says, break it up, as Funk rolls into the rope. Both men ready for battle. They come off of the rope. Ready for action. No love lost between these two. Those, one from Texas, one from Oklahoma. Hey! As action picks up, as crashes get harder, they're battering hammering and tongue. Terry Funk has Bill Watts in the corner, and Watts sliding down that corner of the turnbuckle and on the floor holding his head after being worked over by the unruly tactics of Terry Funk, and Funk throws it in. He's got the North American tank. How it backfires! And look at that strength come to the forefront as Bill Watts upturned the table and uses it to his own good. And now, there goes Funk across the ring. Now, looky who's going. Look at that. Watts has Funk down. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. The bell is rung, and still North American champion, winner over international champion Terry Funk, the winner of the match, ladies and gentlemen. The Oklahoma Sound Theater Cowboy Bill